सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृप्यत्वं अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं मह तदेव अहंत्वं नित्यं मे निश्चिता मतिः। I think we finished the 184th avarta. The tippana. Yeah, nothing there. So continuing with the example of the Ghatakasha, Jalakasha, Mahakasha and the on the exemplified side Brahman description to compare with Mahakasha. That is the only one that's remaining. Jiva has been described. Ishar has been described. Now, what is Brahma? In the example Mahakasha, Brahma Swarupa Vardhanam. Mahakasha Vat Brahmanda Nam Antarvaishya Vyapya Vartamanam Akhanda Paripurna Chaitanyam Brahma Ityuchyate. Comparable to Mahakasha, which is present everywhere. Akasha, Ekaha, Vyapakaha. These are the comparatives with Brahma. Brahma is one, Vyapaka. Sukshma Tattva, Akasha is Sukshma, Brahma is Sukshma. Thereby, Brahmanda, Brahmandanam Antarvahishcha Vyapya, pervading through and through, inside and outside the entire Brahmanda, Vartamanam, which is there, Akhanda Paripurna Chaitanyam. And it is one and also homogeneous without any parts. That is the idea. Paripurna Chaitanyam. Akhanda Paripurna Chaitanyam is called as Brahma. Bhashya Cha Uktam. And Bhagavan Bhashyakara said, Brahma Shabdasya Hi Vyutpadyamanasya Nitya Shuddhatvadayaha Arthaha Pratiyante. Brahma Shabda. How is Brahma the word Shabda itself? So we have Akaranta Pullinga Rama Shabdaha. Then you decline that word. Now Brahma Shabda, how is it declined? Based on the Linga it declines. But Brahma, it is neuter. Pratipadikam Brahma for Nirguna Brahma is Napunsaka Linga. What is the derivation of this Brahman now? It's a Kridanta. Kridanta Shabda, if you look at its Vyutpatti, that's for Brahma Shabdasya Hi Vyutpadyamanasya. When you see how it is being derived, then you know, just by the derivation also, you know it is Nitya Shuddhatvadeha Artha Pratiyante. You realize that it is Yogika Artha. Yogika Artha is by derivation. Vyakrana. You derive using Vyakrana Sutras, you know how you get Brahma Shabda, and thereby Yogika Artha also tells you Nitya Shuddhat, Nityatvam and Shuddhatvam in Brahma. How so? Pratiyante. There is a pratiti of that, such meanings, Nityatvam and Shuddhatvam. Why? Because Brihate Dhatoho Arthanugamat. Just by the Dhatu Artha. Dhatu is Brihivriddhav. सो बृहते बृहते इज बृहु धातु, दोज हैव स्टडीड सूत्रस हियर इक्ष्तिपौ धातु निर्देशे द शुद्ध धातु इज मेंट बाय बृहते। बृहते इज षष्टी एक वचनम बृहती एंड बृहती इज बृहती इज नॉट तिंगंता इट इज सुबंता। सो बृहते धातु एंड इट रिप्रेजेंट द शुद्ध धातु इंडिकेट्स द धातु दिस धातु बृहते धातो अर्थानुगमात यू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ बृह धातु वट इज सर्वस्य आत्मत्वाच्च ब्रह्म अस्तित्व प्रसिद्धि एंड इट इज नॉट ओनली यौगिक अर्थ बिकॉज इफ यू कंपेयर यौगिक अर्थ मीनिंग द टेक्निकल डेरिवेशन वर्सेस रूढ़ी अर्थ, रूढ़ी अर्थ अर्थ बलियान। वेन यू कंपेयर बिटवीन द टू यौगिक अर्थ रूढ़ी अर्थयो हो रूढ़ी अर्थ बलियान। रूढ़ी अर्थ टेक्स प्राइमरी इंपॉर्टेंस कंपेयर टू द डिराइव्ड मीनिंग बिकॉज दैट्स हाउ इट इज यूज इन द लैंग्वेज। द डेरिवेशन इज टू एक्सप्लेन द लैंग्वेज द वर्ड इन द लैंग्वेज सो इट कैनॉट टेक प्रायोरिटी। जनरल रूल उत्सर्ग। देयरफॉर व्हाट इज द रूढ़ी अर्थ दिस इज द क्वेश्चन। सर्वस्य आत्मत्वाच्च ब्रह्म अस्तित्व प्रसिद्धि ब्रह्मास्तत्व प्रसिद्धि विथ रूढ़ी अर्थ ऑल्सो वॉट इज द प्रसिद्धि। ब्रह्म द मीनिंग ऑफ ब्रह्म इज अस्तित्व अस्थि ब्रह्म अस्थि। हाउ सर्वस्य आत्मत्वात् एज द इनर मोस्ट बीइंग ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी एंटिटी दैट इज ब्रह्म। थ्रू रूढ़ी अर्थ ऑल्सो एंड थ्रू यौगिक अर्थ ऑल्सो यू लैंड ऑन द सेम मीनिंग इति दिस सेड इन द फर्स्ट ब्रह्म सूत्र। रत्न प्रभायम अपि एवं व्याख्यातम। सो ऑन द भाष्य देर इज अ रत्न प्रभा टीका ऑन ब्रह्म सूत्र। देर ऑल्सो द एक्सप्लेनेशन गिवन अंडर दिस सूत्र अथा तो ब्रह्म जिज्ञासा दट इज ए सूत्र। देन देर इज दिस भाष्य ऑन दिस भाष्य भगवान टीकाकार दे रत्न प्रभा टीका सेज सच अर्थो महत्व रूपः इति व्याकरणात् निश्चीयते। By Brihi Vriddhau, in the meaning of Vriddhi, you know the meaning of Vriddhi is Mahatvam, Mahantatva, Mahatatva. Vyakranat Nishchiyate, it is ascertained through Vyakrana. Brihi Vriddhau, it is Smaranat, because there is a meaning in Dhatu Patha. Smaranat means in the Dhatu Patha, it's recalled as Brihi Vriddhau. साच वृद्धिर निरवधिकम महत्वम इति संकोच का भावात श्रुतौ अनंत पदेन सह प्रयोगाच ज्ञायते इति। सो दिस वृद्धि साच वृद्धि ब्रूहि वृद्धौ इन देयर वृद्धि इज महत्व रूप। हाउ डू यू नो दैट निरवधिक महत्वम दैट महत्व महत् मीनिंग महत् मीनिंग इज निरवधिकम। There is no avadhi to it. There is no limit. Limitations are brought about by adjectives. If you have any noun, substantive, the limitation is by the adjective. Radhika ji, kindly switch off your video. I had mentioned it last time also. If there's a video, I would like to see the person sitting there, not walking around or anything like that. So kindly switch off your video. If you want to roam around, it is your, you know, prerogative. You can decide what you want to do during the class, but please don't show it to others. I had mentioned it multiple times. I will remove the person who is walking around with the video on. It is very distracting. Those who have taught or those who have children also, they know. If you are talking to your family members and they are just roaming around, not listening to you, it's not right. So whatever be the urgency, you can switch off your video or drop out of the class and then do whatever you like. So sacha artha mahatva rupa iti vyakranat nishchiyate brihi vriddhav iti smarana sacha vriddhi niravadika mahatvam iti. How is it without limits? Because there is no limiting word there. Vriddhi meaning big. There is growth. How big? वी डू नॉट नो हाउ बिग अनलेस सम एडजेक्टिव इज एडेड. विशेषण लिमिट्स दी दी सब्सटैंटिव देयर. हियर जस्ट दि धातु अर्थ शुद्ध धातु अर्थ विथ मनीन प्रत्यय There's an unadi pratyaya which is added, bruhi, vruddhau, plus manin pratyaya gives you brahma. There is nothing to limit. So example, if you look at it, if you say a huge mountain, you do not know how big, is it a hill, just a hillock, or is it a mountain, then you have to add how big. There, the mountain is a substantive and then you add it's a small mountain it's a big mountain it's a huge mountain it's Himalayan or you know comparable to Everest these are the adjectives given to qualify the bigness of the mountain really if you look at it we have reversed the adjective and the substantive It will be clear if you look at other examples. You know, a big car. When you say a big car versus a big mountain, mountain, although mountain is the substantive and car is the substantive in the other phrase, the bigness is common, but still you get different ideas. The bigness is common between the two, big car versus big mountain, but you know, big Himalayan mountain versus a huge SUV car. Or you compare an elephant, you know, tiny elephant, a big elephant. So this bigness, if you reverse the noun and the adjective, and then you qualify the bigness itself, how big? So if someone says it's big, how big? I'm explaining something, you know, I saw something and then I explained it is big. How big was it? Something you don't know. So I'm describing something, it was big. How big it was? Was it mountain big? Was it elephant big? Was it a car, a size of a car? There you'll qualify the bigness with some adjective that is otherwise used as noun. In the gold ornament examples also we have seen when we say the gold bangle a gold necklace gold is common across all this gold is common a gold ring there the gold golden is used as an adjective to the substantives ring necklace etc bangle however if you reverse it the substantive is really gold they do not have a presence without gold There's no bangle, there's no golden bangle without gold. So gold is really the substantive where it is, whereas the usage of noun is erroneous. It should be a bangle shaped gold, a ring shaped gold or a ring sized gold, sized and shaped with a name as well. Gold which is shaped as a ring, sized as a ring, and named as a ring all these are adjectives to gold the gold is the real substantive similarly with the necklace or the bangle or whatever have you that is the case with brahman also the existence appears existence meaning satchit ananda brahma that brahma appears in a different sense different way in as a prapancha when you qualify it with a nama rupatmaka prapancha otherwise this brihi vriddhau does not have an adjective at all whether the bigness is as big as a mountain as big as an elephant as big as a car as big as a mosquito when you compare the bigness of the mosquito you do not look at the elephant size you know you look at this huge mosquito even if you say big or huge mosquito nobody is going to look up You know, the angle will not be so much as if searching for an elephant-sized or a mountain-sized mosquito. People understand by the mosquito, how big can it be? Even if it is huge, how huge can it be? You will compare only at the level of the mosquitoes, not at the level of an elephant or a car or a mountain. So those are the qualifiers for the bigness, which is the real substantive there. In the example, bigness is the, or gold is the substantive. Similarly here, vriddhi, with the meaning vriddhi, Brahma is the substantive. Brihi vriddho, that Brahma, brihi vriddho, derived from that, the dhatu does not show you any limitations. No qualifier, no adjective is limiting it. Thereby, its meaning is infinity. Purnatvam, anantyam. That is the meaning by the Shuddha Dhatvartha. That is said here. Now, when you talk about adjectives, you see here, vriddhi niravadika mahatvam iti. Sacha vriddhi niravadika mahatvam iti. Sankocha bhava shrutau anantapadena saha prayogacha jnayate. You know it through Vyakrana Shastra also. Sankocha ka bhava. There is no limitation by anything, by any other which changes the meaning, limits the meaning in one way or the other. No nama rupatmaka limitation is there, which are otherwise seen in desha, kala or vastu. So desha paricheda, kala paricheda and vastu paricheda is not seen just by looking at the brahma vriddho dhatvartha. Therefore, the purnatva meaning, there is nothing to taint it also. Shuddhatva meaning is also revealed by the same dhatu. And since it is not limited, you cannot limit it in time also. Nityatvam is also revealed by the same dhatvartha. In the Shruti, the definition is Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma. So Anantapadena, Shrutau Api Anantapadena Sahaprayogacha. Brahma has been used in the sentence with Anantapada, where Anantapada is a Lakshana. It's a defining word. Ananta, if Brihi Vriddhau, the Vriddhi was limited, then Anantapada Prayog wouldn't have been there. It would be contradictory. Therefore, Anantapada Shruti reveals so that the Brihi Vriddho, the Vriddhi Artha is without any limits. Iti. Ataha Brihanad Brahma iti Vyutpatya Desha Kala Vastukrata Paricheda Bhava Rupam Nityatvam Pratiyate. Therefore, Brihanad Brahma, due to being huge, it is called as Brahma. Anantatvam is known, that becomes a hetu for Brahma to be, the vyutpatti becomes a hetu. Through the vyutpatti, desha kala vastukruta paricheda bhavarupam nityatvam pratiyate. You land on nityatvam as a meaning. Why? Because there is no desha paricheda, kala paricheda, vastu paricheda. Although kala paricheda shows you that things cannot be nitya, vastu also limits its nityatvam. And desha paricheda also limits its nityatvam. But none of these are possible for Brahma, where there is no limitation any which way. Ananta Brahma iti cha. Tatha suta sahita vyakhyana vyakhyane api uktam. Yeah. Tatha suta sahita vyakhyane api uktam. So suta sahita, this suta sahita is said to be, studied 8 times by Bhagavan Bhashyakara before he wrote Bhashya. 8 times he went through Suta Samhita and then he wrote Bhashyas on Upanishads, etc. On Prasthanatraya. So quite an important work. And in Suta Samhita, on Suta Samhita, there is a Vyakhyana written by Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya, who says, Brahma Satya Jnana Sukhad Dvayam Brihadhatvartasya Anugamat. This Brahma is Satyam Jnanam सुखम आनंद एंड अद्वय. वाई बृहद बृह बृही वृद्ध बृहद धात्वर्थस्य अनुगमात् बिकॉज वी नो द मीनिंग ड्यू टू द मीनिंग इन द धातु पार्ट ऑल्सो वी कैन सी द सत्य ज्ञान सुखाद्वयम थ्रू द धात्वर्थ इटसेल्फ. तथा ही बृह बृही वृद्धौ इति धातु धातुः वृद्धिम आचष्टे. सो द धातु पाठ गिव्स द मीनिंग एज वृद्धि. सा च वृद्धि प्रतियोगी विशेषानुपादान पादानात् निरतिशया एव विवक्षिता. सो प्रतियोगी विशेषानुपादानात् निरतिशया एव, वी हैव सीन दिस, विवक्षिता. इंटेंशन ऑफ द बृही वृद्धौ लिस्टिंग इन द धातु पाठ विदाउट एनी प्रतियोगी और विशेष नो विशेष विशेषण इज नॉट गिवन देयर. देयर इज नो काउंटर पार्ट टू इट. देयर इज नथिंग व्हिच इज अदर देन ब्रह्म रियली. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज मेंशन्ड एज वृद्धि विदाउट एनी लिमिटेशन. देयरफॉर निरतिशय डज नॉट हैव एनी लिमिटेशन. दैट इज इंटेंशन. सती च वस्तुअंतरे तेन परिच्छेदाद वृत्तेः निरतिशयत्वं भज्येत. सो सति च वस्तुअंतरे वस्तुअंतरे सति हैड देयर बीन एनी अदर वस्तु अन्य वस्तु वस्तुअंतरम तस्मिन् वस्तुअंतरे सति हैड देयर बीन एनी अदर वस्तु अदर देन ब्रह्म. दैट इज द मीनिंग. वसति इति वस्तु वसति इज एग्जिस्ट. सत्ता इज रिवील्ड बाय दि वसति. वस्तु मीन्स दैट विच एग्जिस्ट. दैट कैन बी ओनली ब्रह्म. अदर देन ब्रह्म नथिंग एग्जिस्ट. एवरीथिंग बोरोज फ्रॉम ब्रह्म फॉर देयर वास फॉर देयर सत्ता. देयर फॉर वस्तुअंतरे सति हैड देयर बीन एनी अदर वस्तु देयर इज नो अदर वस्तु. देयर इज ओनली वन वस्तु अदरवाइज कॉल्ड एज ब्रह्म. देन सच वस्तु कुड हैव कॉज परिच्छेद लिमिटेशन. तेन परिच्छेदात् वृद्धेः निरतिशयत्वं भज्येत. दैट निरतिशयत्वं कुड बी लिमिटेड. यू कुड डिवाइड इट से ओके दिस इज वन वस्तु दिस इज अनदर वस्तु बट यू डू नॉट हैव एनी वस्तु परिच्छेद. देयर इज नो अदर वस्तु टू कॉल कॉज परिच्छेद इन ब्रह्म. तथा च वस्तुअंतर कृत परिच्छेद रहितमेव ब्रह्म शब्द वाच्यं भवितुम अर्हति. रियल मीनिंग ऑफ ब्रह्म हैज टू बी that which is bereft of any paricheda created by another vastu. Because of what reason? Because of no other vastu being there. Dvaita prapanchasya tatswarupe adhyasthataya eva pratitehe vastutaha tatswarupa anatiriktatvat. What about this entire prapancha? Such a vast prapancha is there. How do you say that there is no vastuantaram? And thereby tatkruta paricheda. Dvaita prapanchasya tatswarupe adhyastataya. On Brahman, the real nature of Brahma is anantyam. On that Brahma, if you superimpose a dual prapancha, plurality, prapancha which has plurality, that is not going to change the swarupa. Tat swarupe adhyasataya. Atasmin tad buddhi. Where dvaita prapancha is not. Atasmin is na dvaita prapancha. I don't want to say advaita prapancha. So I'll say na. When there is no dvaita prapancha. We can say that advaita. अद्वैते ब्रह्मणि द्वैत प्रपंचस्य. सो अद्वैत ब्रह्म. अद्वैत ब्रह्म इज न द्वैत. सो अद्वैते द्वैत बुद्धि इज अतस्मिन् तद्बुद्धि. इन नॉन द्वैत देयर इज द्वैत बुद्धि. सो आई कैन ऑल्सो से अद्वैत प्रपंचे. अद्वैत प्रपंचे इज नॉट प्रपंच ऑफ अद्वैत. But dvaita prapancha is negated by nanch. यत्र द्वैत प्रपंच नास्ति तत्र द्वैत प्रपंचस्य बुद्धि द्वैत प्रपंच बुद्धि इज अतस्मिन् तद्बुद्धि एंड वेर इज दैट तस्मिन् तस्मिन् इज ब्रह्मात्मनि ब्रह्मात्मनि यत्र द्वैत प्रपंच नास्ति तत्र द्वैत प्रपंच बुद्धि इज अध्यास एंड अध्यस्ततया द्वैत प्रपंचस्य तत्स्वरूपे अद्वैत ब्रह्मस्वरूपे एव प्रतीतेः देयर इज ओनली अ प्रतीति हाउ बाय अध्यास ड्यू टू अध्यास देयरफॉर वस्तुतः इन रियलिटी तत्स्वरूप अनतिरिक्तत्वात् तत्स्वरूपानतिरिक्तत्वात् देयर इज नथिंग अदर देन दि अद्वैत स्वरूप ब्रह्म स्वरूपत वस्तुत देयर इज नो भेद एट ऑल देयर इज नो द्वैत प्रपंच विच इज रियल तथा च वस्तुकृत परिच्छेद निराकरणेनैव देशकालकृत परिच्छेद अपि निरस्तो वेदितव्यः सो हियर साधु टेक्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग अप्रोच ही सेज आई नीड नॉट टॉक अबाउट देशकाल परिच्छेद एट ऑल जस्ट बाय निगेटिंग वस्तु परिच्छेद बाय सेइंग वसति इति वस्तु दैट वस्तु इज ब्रह्म देयर इज नो अदर वस्तु देयरफॉर देश therefore vastu paricheda is not possible and when vastu paricheda is denied negated then deshakala paricheda also are as good as denied why so because desha and kala are talked in the context of various vastus in the dvaita prapancha you will have a talk of desha and kala when there is only one brahma desha kala talk cannot be possible before you say in some desha you have to have dvaita prapancha akasha there akasha is part of dvaita prapancha only when akasha comes about then you can talk about desha but akasha is rejected as a different vastu at all because of it being adhyastha अध्यस्ततया एव प्रतीति आकाश प्रतीति इज ओनली ड्यू टू अध्यास देयरफॉर आकाश इज नॉट सिद्ध एज अ द्वितीय वस्तु देयर बाय वस्तु परिच्छेद इज नॉट पॉसिबल नाउ इफ इट इज नॉट सिद्ध एज अ वस्तु हाउ विल यू टॉक अबाउट देश बिकॉज आकाश इज इन देयर देश कैनॉट बी टॉक्ड अबाउट काला कैनॉट बी टॉक्ड अबाउट बिकॉज एनी थिंग टू बी फॉर काला टू बी टॉक्ड अबाउट यू नीड समथिंग एल्स That Kala is also in the Dvaita Prapancha. Basically, you can just say Desha and Kala are a part of Vyavaharika Prapancha. So, Sadhu says that Vastukruta Paricheda Nirakarani Neyu. By just negation, by the negation of just the Vastu Paricheda, Vastukruta Paricheda, Desha Kala Kruta Paricheda also Nirastha Veditavya. We should understand as they are also negated. Divisions created by Desha and Kala are not possible in Brahma. Desha Kala yorapi parikalpitatvena vastutah tadrupa anatirekat. Tadrupa anatirekat. Vastutah. In reality, you cannot have kalpita Desha and Kala affecting. Evam and anat. Basically, kalpita vastu, what is the reality of kalpita vastu? Adhishthana. Adhishthana taya eva sattvam. So, desha kala are parikalpita. If you inquire into their reality, their satta is borrowed from adhishthana, which happens to be Brahma. Because adhyasa is on tatswarupa, Brahma swarupa. Evam dvaita aparokshasya adhishthana tvena तद् बाधावदित्वेन च त्रिविध परिच्छेद रहितं यद् अद्वितीयं तत् सत्यम् एव एष्टव्यम् इति सो एज एन अधिष्ठान ऑफ द्वैत द्वैत विच इज क्लियर टू यू बट देर इज ओनली अ प्रतीति प्रतीति इज ड्यू टू बोरोइंग सत्ता फ्रॉम अधिष्ठान They are all kalpita on the adhishthana brahma. Therefore, that is one reason. And then, tad brahma badhavaditvena. Avadhi, the limitation has been refuted. There is no limitation possible. We have seen through Vyakrana as well as Shruti and then other commentaries there. Tenacha, Trivida Parichheda Rahitam Yad Advitiyam Brahma. That Trivida Parichheda, Desha Kala Vastu Parichheda Rahitam, bereft of any of these three limitations, that Advitiya Brahma is definitely to be known as Satyam. It has to be Satya. Satyam Eshtavyam. Satyam Eva Eshtavyam. Idancha Brahma Na Dure Napyantike Vartate. Is this Brahma Dura or, you know, Tat Shabda? Tat Shabda Prayoga is done only when it is Dura. So Tat Brahma. When you say Yad Advitiyam Tat Satyam, then Tat Shabda. Tat Shabda shows that it is far away. Then only you should use Tat. Otherwise, you would have used Etat. Esha Atma. But Tad Brahma. So, Idam also. Idam Cha Brahma. Now, which has gone by in the sentence, Idam Cha Brahma. Idam is used for Jagat also. Idam Jagat. Comparatively near to Tad Brahma. Tad Brahma, Idam Jagat. But Esha Atma. Esha, Etat Shabda. Prayoga is done for, which is very close. How close? Pratyagatma, Swarupa Abheda. There is nothing closer to you than yourself. There Esha Atma. Tat is very far, Brahma. But then Tat Tvamasi, you are that. And then Idam Khalvidam Brahma. Therefore, Idam Cha Brahma, this Jagat is an appearance of Brahma. That Brahma Na Dure Napi Antike Vartate. It is neither far nor near. You cannot have such possibilities of usage of word as well. Words such as Duram, Antikam. You cannot say that. Why? Because there is no possibility of Desha even. Desha is Mithya. Yadhi Vastu Swasmad Anyatvena Anatma Bhutam Deshadi Rupo Upadhi Parichinancha Bhavati Tadeva Dure Antikeva Vartata Ityuchyate. Can talk about Dura and Antika when Desha is possible. Desha is an Upadhi. Thereby there is Parichinnata. Only then you can talk about Dura or Antika when Vastu Paricheda is there. One Vastu is far from another. Then you have Dura or Antika. Or near. Then you say Antika, closer. Swasmad Anyatvena. Even if you say no, there is no second Vastu. There is only one. I am talking about something in the prapancha, ghata. Ghata is one, there is nothing other than ghata. But the person who is saying he is existent, he says that the ghata is dura, ghata is near. When you are talking about ghata as far or near, then that ghata has to be siddha as different from you. Swasmadanyatvena anatma bhutam. There is nothing called anatma. It is mithya. There is no real anatma. So you cannot say there is, it is, this anatma is dura or antika. Idantu brahma. This brahma na pratyagatmana bhidyate. Tattvamasi is the shruti vakya where brahma is pratyagatma. When you remove the upadis, then brahma and pratyagatma are different names for the same vastu. Therefore, idam tu brahmana pratyagatmano bhidyate, na bhidyate. It is not different from pratyagatma. Real swarupa of jiva and brahma swarupa are not different. Kim tarhi, sarvasya pratyagatma bhutam deshadi rupa sarvopadi shunyam cha bhavati. Sarvasya pratyagatma bhutam, being the innermost self of everything. How? Ahantaya, aham aham. I am. Then I am this or that is an addition. But I am. I exist. I am conscious. There is no limitation there either. When you say I am aham, aham asmi, aham bhami, where is the limitation there? When you add any of the koshas or shariras, aham, you give a name to aham. Aham praveenaha. Then this Praveena is born in time. अहम देवदत्ता, अहम यज्ञदत्ता, बोर्न इन टाइम. देश काल परिच्छेद इज पॉसिबल फॉर दैट वन हू हैज षड विकारास बिकॉज जन्म इज देयर, बट दिस ब्रह्म इज अजात ब्रह्म. आत्मा इज अजात, अहम इज अजात. अहम देवदत्ता, देन देवदत्ता वॉज बॉर्न इन टाइम, देर वॉज नामकरण, ही इज गोइंग टू डाई इन टाइम, देर इज काल परिच्छेद वस्तु परिच्छेद, सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम हिज मदर बॉडीली, सेपरेटेड इन सेंस बॉडीली सेपरेटेड ड्यूरिंग बर्थ, सो देर इज कारक भेद आर देर. देर फोर देवदत्ता वेन यू क्वालिफाई अहम, जस्ट लाइक वी आर कॉल वी सी ब्रूहि वृद्ध, अहम इज क्वालिफाइड बाय विशेषण. वेन आई से अहम अहम देवदत्ता, देन दैट देवदत्ता इज लिमिटिंग द अहम, अदरवाइज अहम इज फ्री. देर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन अहम दैट देवदत्ता सेज वर्सेस यज्ञदत्ता सेज वर्सेस आई से यू से एनीवन सेज. प्रथम पुरुष मध्यम पुरुष उत्तम पुरुष ऑल आर फ्रॉम द पर्सपेक्टिव ऑफ द उत्तम पुरुष अहम, दैट अहम इज नॉट डिफरेंट. इफ इवन इफ यू विथ ग्रेट रिस्पेक्ट यू आस्क भवान किम करोति भवती किम करोति, देयर द आंसर इज ओनली अहम. आंसर इज नॉट इन थर्ड पर्सन और सेकेंड पर्सन, द आंसर इज अहम. वेन द आचार्य इज टीचिंग श्वेतकेतु तत्त्वमसि, यू आर दैट, सो तत् इज प्रथम पुरुष, त्वम इज मध्यम पुरुष. बट देन व्हाट इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग, इफ द शिष्य अंडरस्टैंड श्वेतकेतु अंडरस्टैंड्स एज दैट इज यू, इट इज मीनिंगलेस. बट वी ऑल नो द लैंग्वेज, व्हेन यू हैज बीन यूज्ड इट हैज टू बी रिप्लेस्ड, व्हेन रिसीव्ड इट हैज टू बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय अहम, इट विल बिकम उत्तम पुरुष. And that Uttama Purusha is none other than Purushottama of the Gita 15th chapter, Purushottama Yoga. It's just swapping of the words in the Samasa. Yaha Uttama Purusha Saya Purushottama. That is that Brahma Sarvasya Pratyagatma Bhutam Aham Aham Taya Vartate. That is Pratyagatma. Therefore, Brahmatma, who cannot be shown as different, the I in you and I in me cannot be. I in you and I in me is not really I in. There is no Adhikarana. I in a sense, in the statement, I in when you make the statement as I am something, that you drop that something as an Upadhi. When I say I am someone, I drop that Upadhi. The conscious existent I cannot have anta. So it is satchit as well as ananta, because anta is brought about by an upadhi. When I make a nama rupa upadhi, I am a man, I am a woman, I am an engineer, I am a doctor, I am a CA, I am a father, I am a mother. All these divisions are brought about by upadhis. But just that I am, aham asmi. Asmi is possible only when aham bhami. I can make that statement, aham asmi, only when I shine forth as I. Aham asmi, aham bhami. That is my reality. Beyond that, all these are upadhis. And that aham cannot be two. सर्वस्य प्रत्यगात्म भूतम इदं ब्रह्म देशादि रूप सर्वोपाधि शून्यं च भवति, इज विदाउट एनी उपाधीज विच आर क्रिएटेड बाय देश काल और वस्तु बीइंग सेपरेट फ्रॉम आत्मा विच आर नॉट देयर, दे आर ऑल उपाधीज विच आर मिथ्या, तस्मादेव तद्दूरे अंतिके वा वर्तमानतया न उच्यते, कैनॉट से दैट फार और नियर. Because it is very swarupa, your own very swarupa, you cannot say, you cannot really say tat, you have to say aham. You cannot say tvam, you have to say aham. There is no choice but for this aham to shine forth as aham, Brahma to shine forth as aham. there is no other possibility. There is no possibility of objectifying this Brahma at all. Brahma shabda sihi vachya artha sopadika eva. However, when you generally talk of Brahma, who is this Brahma? In the first sutra also, second sutra, athato Brahma jidnyasa there, and then continuing with anuvritti in the Brahma sutras. Who is this Brahma? Brahma jidnyasa. When you say Brahma jidnyasa, generally, Brahma shabda sihi vachya artha. When you say who is this Brahma? Tad Brahma. Idam sarvam Brahma. Idam khalu idam Brahma. Idam khalu Brahma. So idam sarvam khalvidam brahma. So sarvam khalvi sarvam jagat khalu idam brahma. When you say that, there what do you mean by this sarva is brahma? That brahma is sopadika brahma, ishvara ityata saguna brahma. Generally when you say brahma, there are two ways in brahma in which the word brahma is used. One is as saguna brahma, one is as nirguna brahma. Both meanings are possible. When should you take which meaning? So one has to know that Brahma shabda si vachya artha. Even when I say aham, the real meaning of aham is pratyagatma. However, when I say aham, generally so upadhika aham, aham devadatta. When I say aham, nobody thinks that I am talking about atma. So Brahma shabda si vachya artha so upadhika eva. Along with upadhi, व्यापकत्व धर्म विशिष्टस्य वस्तुनः ब्रह्म शब्दाभिधेयत्वात्. जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट, टू मच ऑफ रेन, आई कैन बेयरली हियर माय सेल्फ. ओके, सो ब्रह्म शब्दस्य वाच्यार्थ सोपादिक व्यापकत्व धर्म विशिष्टस्य वस्तुनः ब्रह्म शब्दाभिधेयत्वात्. ब्रह्म वी हैव सीन मीनिंग एज वृद्धौ also gives the meaning of vyapaka tattva. It has to be everywhere. Eshavasyam idam sarvam. There Brahma meaning is when any vyapaka shabda, it is called as Brahma. Idam cha vyapakattvam dividam. What is this vyapakattvam? All pervasive. When it is all pervasive, it is of two types. Sapeksham meaning satishayam, or nirapeksham niratishayam cheti. Vyapakatva can be limited as well. It is pervasive, but how pervasive? So there, whether it has a limit or doesn't have a limit, based on that, sapeksham or satishayam is a word used when it has a limitation. Nirapeksham, niratishayam, when it does not have a limit. Yadvastu svavyapyapekshaya vyapakam. So that which is vyapakam. See here, nul pratyaya has been used. You are anako, so you'll get aka. So vyapaka. Vyapaka means the karta, vyapana karta. That is the meaning of this aka or nul pratya, which becomes aka. It means it's a kartari vyutpatti. So vyapaka is one who does vyapanam, one who, that entity which pervades, kartari meaning. And vyapya is karmani yak. So karmani is a karma, not yak, yat. Yat or nyat pratyas are used for karmani vyutpatti. So vyapya means karma and vyapaka means karta. So this means vyapaka means pervader and vyapya means that which is pervaded. So yadvastu sva vyapya apekshaya, compared to that which is pervaded by itself, so compared to that which is a pervader, meaning which covers more than that which is pervaded. It covers more than the pervaded. Then svavyapaka pekshaya vyapyam cha bhavati. And svavyapaka pekshaya vyapyam cha bhavati. Not only that, if that pervader, this pervader is also pervaded by something else. So svavyapaka pekshaya, that which pervades this pervader, in a series of, you know, if you look at, there is Vastu 1, Vastu 2 and Vastu 3. If Vastu 1 is pervaded by Vastu 2 and this Vastu 2 pervades the Vastu 1 and goes beyond that, meaning covers a larger space. In simple words, let's just say, just take an example of space and see, covers a larger space. Of course, you have to look at time, vastu, kala and vastu also. But let's just take one example, easy to see, desha. So the vastu one is pervaded by vastu two completely, and swavyapyapeksha vyapakam, it pervades more than that. Then further, vastu three exists, which pervades this vastu two, and so vyapakapekshaya vyapyam cha bhavati. But then compared to the pervader, this is not pervaded completely, vastu two, tad apekshika vyapakam ityuchyate. Meaning what? It is covering only, it is tad apekshika vyapakam, means there is a limitation to vyapana. There is a limitation to vyapana. I should not use vastu three there. Should not have used vastu three anyway. Here basically what is said is that how much is the vyapya pervaded by vyapaka. That is the idea. That is the basic idea. How much is it pervading? Based on that, there is apekshika vyapakatvam or there is nirapekshika vyapakatvam. Let's look further, it will be clearer in the flip side. Yatha prithivyadi, example will make it clear. Yatha prithivyadi rupas swakaryapekshaya vyapini maya. So vastu through, I'm just saying, vastu is only one, but I mentioned as vastu one, vastu two, vastu three. Here in the example, look at vastu one is prithivi, and then yatha prithivyadi rupa swakaryapeksha vyapini maya chaitanyapeksha tu vyapini kintu vyapya natu tu na vyapini kintu vyapya. So in the example that I mentioned, prithivi, here prithivi, maya and chaitanya, these three things are taken as v1 v2 v3, vastu 1 vastu 2 vastu 3. Now this maya pervades prithivyadi but is pervaded by chaitanya. So in the last thing I made a mistake. So swa vyapakapeksha vyapyam cha bhavati means you look at the example instead of v1 v2, we will take this example and revisit the earlier sentence. So yatha prithivyadi rupa swa karya apeksha vyapini maya. So maya has its own karya. Swakarya is what? Prithivyadi. Because Prithivyadi have come from Maya. Maya is Vyapini, meaning Vyapini means Vyapaka. Vyapaka. Vyapaka word in feminine here, Vyapini has been used. Of course, a different pratyaya, but in the same Kartari meaning. So Maya is a Kartri, Vyapana Kartri. And Vyapya, which is pervaded is Prithivyadi. Because swakarya, its own karya, maya pervades through its karya. Everything, every karana pervades its karya. Now the vastu three, which is the real vastu, is chaitanya. Chaitanya apekshaya tu vyapna na vyapini. Does not pervade chaitanya though. Chaitanya is karana. Karana or rather adhishthana for maya also. Kintu vyapya. Maya is pervaded by chaitanya. But ekadesha of chaitanya is pervaded maya. That is the meaning here. Swavyapakapekshaya vyapyam cha bhavati. Compared to the swavyapaka, brahma, chaitanya, maya is vyapya. Vyapyam cha bhavati, maya is srilingi, therefore vyapya cha bhavati. It is pervaded by its own pervader, and that pervader is larger than maya, larger in the sense that brahmi vriddhav, therefore larger, only one desha is maya. That's the idea there. So what kind of maya will be vyapaka tattva, but what kind of vyapaka tattva? It will be apekshika vyapaka. Tad apekshika vyapaka mityuchyate. Therefore maya will be apekshika, will have apekshika vyapakatvam. तस्मान मायायाम आपेक्षिकम्यो व्यापकत्वम अस्ति. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ व्यापकत्वम डज माया हैव? आपेक्षिक. इट इज रिलेटिव. सो वी अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग थ्रू द एग्जांपल. निरपेक्षिकम, निरपेक्ष व्यापकत्वम इज नॉट देयर इन माया बट ओनली आपेक्षिक व्यापकत्वम. रिलेटिव, रिलेटिवली परवेसिव, परवेड्स बट नॉट कंप्लीटली, ओनली रिलेटिवली. कंपेयर टू द वर्ल्ड, यस, माया परवेड्स द एंटायर प्रपंच. But Chaitanya is outside of it in the sense, Chaitanya is not pervaded by Maya, Maya is pervaded by Chaitanya. Anyway, let's drop the technicalities, we get the idea. Now, what is Chaitanya? Chaitanya is completely pervasive, therefore nirapeksha vyapakatvam for Chaitanya. Yad vastu sarvapekshaya vyapakam bhavati tannishta vyapakatvam nirapeksha vyapakatvam ityuchyate. So that which is completely pervading others, it is pervading the prapancha and its karya maya also, karana maya also. Therefore, the karya prapancha and karana maya is pervaded by the adhishthana chaitanya. Therefore, chaitanya pervades everything. Thereby, it has nirapeksha vyapakatvam. Idancha nirapeksha vyapakatvam chaitanya eva vartate. There is nothing else which has nirapeksha vyapakatvam. Even if you take vyavaharika satta and you talk about maya and other karyas, they'll all have limited vyapakatvam. Na tat samaschabhyadikascha drishyate ityadi shrutya tat samamvadikam va na kinchanam vyapakam vastu vidyata iti siddhatvat. There is nothing similar to Brahma. There is nothing greater than Brahma. So there is no other Brahma, there is no other Abrahma also. That is the idea given the Shvetashvetra mantra that is quoted here. Thereby, tat samam, meaning Brahma samam, va adhikam, va. More than that, bigger than that, vyapaka than that does not exist. Therefore, its vyapakatvam is the highest. And there is none other which has such vyapakatvam. So sama is not there. Therefore, there is only one Chaitanya. Chaitanya eva nirapeksha vyapakatvam vartate. This has been established iti siddhatvat through shruti. Tasma chaitanyasya eva sarvapeksha vyapakatva shravanat tadeva nirapeksha vyapakam iti siddhyati. Therefore, logically also and through shruti, it has been established that Chaitanya alone has nirapeksha vyapakatvam. एतद् द्विविध व्यापकत्व विशिष्टं वस्तु ब्रह्म शब्दस्य वाच्यार्थः. सो द्विविध व्यापकत्व विशिष्टं वस्तु. नाउ दिस ब्रह्म शब्द, वेयर डिड इट स्टार्ट, व्हाई डिड दिस हैज दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन कम अप? बिकॉज़ ब्रह्म शब्दस्य ही वाच्यार्थः. व्हेन इट इज सेड तत्त्वमसि, देयर तत् शब्द ब्रह्म शब्द वाच्यार्थः. व्हाट इज द वाच्यार्थः? सोपादिक एव. देयरफॉर देयर विल बी द्विविध व्यापकत्व विशिष्ट ब्रह्म शब्द. निरपेक्ष व्यापकत्वम हैज टू बी देयर एंड देयर इज सोपादिक और आपेक्षिक. आपेक्षिक व्यापकत्वम, बोथ आर पॉसिबल इन ब्रह्म. हाउ सो? बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ब्रह्म. सो एतद् द्विविध व्यापकत्व विशिष्टम वस्तु ब्रह्म शब्दस्य वाच्यार्थः. The literal meaning of Brahma, literal in the sense, in the sentence when Brahma is used, it can have either the nirapeksha vyapakatva meaning or it can have the apekshika vyapakatva meaning. Both are possible. Maya shabalita chaitanye dvividam api etad vyapakatvam vartate. When seen along with Maya, that chaitanya which is along with Maya, there is sagunatvam. Apekshikatvam is there because Maya has apekshika vyapakatvam and Maya is associated with Chaitanya. Thereby, you will have Chaitanya, which is Brahma Shabda Artha. Still, it will be what? It will be limited meaning. Vyapakatvam will have limitation. Dvividam api etad vyapakatvam vartate. There will be both types because Chaitanya is Shuddha Brahma, which is nirapekshika. Because it has been said, Chaitanya eva निरपेक्ष व्यापकत्वं चैतन्येव वर्तते एंड माया शबिलित चैतन्य इज अलोंग विद माया, माया हैज आपेक्षिक व्यापकत्वं वेर एज ब्रह्म चैतन्य हैज निरपेक्ष निरपेक्षक व्यापकत्वं, देयरफॉर बोथ आर देयर, द्विविधं अपि एतद् व्यापकत्वं वर्तते। विशिष्ट निष्ठ विशेषणीभूत माया रूपांशे आपेक्षिक व्यापकत्वं विशेष्यभूत चैतन्यांशे निरपेक्ष व्यापकत्वं च वर्तते, बिकॉज बोथ आर टुगेदर। नाउ ईश्वर शब्द व्हेन यू से ईश्वरः, तत् शब्द वाच्यार्थ ईश्वरः, सगुण ब्रह्म, देयर ब्रह्म चैतन्य इज देयर विच इज having nirapeksha vyapakattvam, whereas maya is also there which has sapekshika vyapakattvam, therefore apekshika vyapakattvam due to maya, maya roopa amsha in the tat shabda or brahma shabda, which is vishishta nishta visheshani bhuta maya. Vishishta is brahma, in that brahma there is visheshana of maya, therefore visheshani bhuta maya, which is an amsha. In that amsha, there is apekshika vyapakatvam and visheshya brahma, which is chaitanya, shuddha chaitanya, visheshya bhuta chaitanya amshe nirapeksha vyapakatvam cha vartate. Chaitanyaika deshe mayayaha sattvat. Because in chaitanya, maya cannot be there everywhere. Maya is only in, although chaitanya does not have any amsha, still maya is trigunatmika maya. That trigunatmika maya can be seen only in one amsha of chaitanya. How we say, you know, chaitanya amsha has become jiva. This is the usage generally. Although there cannot be an amsha in chaitanya, but if you have to talk about maya, is maya everywhere? No, maya is not all pervasive. Only the manifest prapancha is maya, and it itself is unmanifest. However, chaitanya is backing as adhisthana. Complete Chaitanya is not superimposed upon or does not have Maya. Therefore, Chaitanya ekadeshe mayayaha sattvat, Maya vishishta Chaitanya apekshaya shuddha Chaitanyasya adhika vyapakatvaccha tadeva nirapeksha vyapakam. So, Maya vishishta Chaitanya apeksha. Now, you compare the Chaitanya which has Maya, which is connected with Maya, whatever kind of connection, mithya sambandha, but still it is there. Maya vishishta chaitanya and shuddha chaitanya, if you differentiate in words, because vachyartha, we are looking at vachyartha. Lakshyartha does not have any divisions, but vachyartha has divisions. Based on how the usage is, you have to understand in the sentence. That is mimamsa. It is a shabda mimamsa, vakya mimamsa. Shabda jnana, pada jnana has to take place before vakya jnana takes place. Only when vakya jnana takes place, there will be shabda bodha. So to understand any sentence as given by the Shruti or Laukika also, we have to understand the words. Now this Brahma shabda is a loaded word. That's what it means. What is the meaning there? Chaitanya ika deshe maya yaha sattva. Since maya is there only one part of chaitanya, although parts cannot be talked about, but this is vyavaharika usage. Maya vishishta chaitanyapekshaya shuddha chaitanyasya adhika vyapakatvacha tadeva nirapeksha vyapakam, which is that shuddha chaitanya. Shuddha chaitanya, nirguna brahma, has nirapeka, nirapeksha vyapakatvam, whereas maya vishishta chaitanya has apekshika vyapakatvam. This is the idea. On this chaitanya ekadesha, there is a comment. Nahi ghatopadanatva, टिप्पण नहि घटोपादनत्व शक्ति ही मृत्सामान्य वर्तते. नाउ दिस इज द आइडिया गिवन टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज चैतन्य एकदेश. इफ यू टेक घट, घट उपादान कारण इज मृत. क्ले इज द कारण फॉर घट विच इज कार्य उपादान कारण. देर इन दिस उपादान कारण मृत देर इज सम शक्ति. दिस क्ले, if there is clay, not every, if you take a lump of clay, or if you take any mrit, not lump of clay, you take mrit, that mrit, not all mrit can be shaped to ghata. Ghata karya can come from only particular type of mrit, only a particular part of mrit. that mrit does not have shakti of becoming ghata. If you just say, okay, I have clay, but soft clay, which cannot be hardened at all, whatever be the idea, you know, or that which will become very brittle if you heat it up. There are a lot of differences in the clay also. So clay does not have the shakti to become ghata. All parts, all lumps of clay do not have such shakti. All mrit does not have, any mrit won't do for ghata. Ghatakara will want a particular mixture of mrit. Kintu mrit visheshev, there has to be a particular kind of mrit which can create ghata. Evameva, similarly, if you apply to the exemplified, evameva mayana brahmani sarvatra vartate. So extending a meaning, saying that not all kind of chaitanya can appear as with the maya shakti as prapancha. Not the entire. That's why purna madha purnamidam. Purnat purnam. So purnat purnam avashishyate. Purna madha purnamidam. Purnat purnam udachyate. Purnasya purnamaya. So purnam eva avashishyate in the end. When you take away purna from purna, purna remains. This is purna, that is purna, meaning the karana is purna. From karana, karya which has come out is purna. Even if you take away purna from karya, karana still remains as purna. Of course, there is vivartavada also there, but purna meva avashishyate. There is purna which remains. Meaning that purna, even if you take away infinity from infinity, infinity remains in karana. The idea is that only ekadesha. That's why even in Purusha Sukta, however you extend the prapancha, the universe is ever expanding, but the Purusha will always be 10 fingers up. 10 fingers up means what? Not really 10 fingers, it's a measure. Not as a measure, but it is just a word used for infinity. Whether it is dashaungali or whether you say it is shatam, or sahasram, all these are ananta vachya shabda. They are used just to show what does it mean by 10 fingers. Now, if you take exactly 10 fingers also, if the universe keeps on expanding and you say Purusha is 10 fingers above, then universe is expanding, tending to infinity. 10 fingers above will definitely be more than that. However you expand the universe, however the universe expands, the Purusha, the Karana will always be more Vyapaka. Therefore, Nirapeksha Vyapakatvam is there. And evam eva maya na brahmani sarvatra vartate kintu ekadeshe eva. If you think of desha, if you have to do kalpana, in vyavahara you have to do kalpana, manifest chaitanya, if you look at manifest chaitanya as adhisthana, there only in ekadesha you have maya, not everywhere. Natu, so tadeva nirapeksha vyapakatvam natu maya vishishta chaitanyam. So maya vishishta chaitanya is not nirapeksha vyapaka, but only shuddha chaitanya is nirapeksha vyapaka. Tathapi yato maya vishishta chaitanyam paramartha drushtya shuddha chaitanyad anatiriktam sat shuddha rupam eva bhavati tasman maya vishishte api yaha chaitanyamsha tatra nirapekshakam eva Vyapakam asti. We'll see more of this in the next part. Huh? There is some more, but then it's a little terse. So we'll look at it in the next part. Huh? Sukham nityam saprakasham vyapakam namurupya adhishtanam buddhya buddhyam buddhe drukyatnirim aparam sarvedant vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva timi nishchita matihi. Any questions? Prachin, next part. Namaste.
Hari Om.
Hari Om.